guys, welcome back to another video. Today, it's a beautiful Saturday. It's like 55, almost 60 degrees today. Hardly any wind. Got my boy AJ behind the camera. We're gonna be doing some wintertime bass fishing today. It's late January. Water temps are kind of cold. We're gonna be using drop shots, spinner baits, jigs, just anything we can find to get these wintertime fish to bite. Yesterday, me and AJ went out to a private lake. Didn't get any footage of that, but ended up catching some pretty nice fish. Today, we're gonna take the camera with us and see if we can't replicate that today for you guys. So, y'all stay tuned, it's gonna be a banger. But first, let's go get some breakfast. All right, made it from breakfast, made it to the first location. Pond's actually straight through these trees. It's actually a pond I have not fished on video with you guys before, but for y'all that are wondering, this is man AJ. He was the guy behind the camera earlier in the intro. And AJ, you ready to get on some today?
Yeah, we're gonna rip lips.
Show them what we're using today. Bass Pro Shops brand drop shot worm in bold bluegill color. I don't know what it is, but it seems like we've been catching a lot of bass on that lately. It's like a chartreuse and brown drop shot worm. So hopefully we can go catch some in here. We have not been here in a while, but we're gonna go give this shot. It's worth a try. So stay tuned, wish us luck. All you guys wondering what the bait looks like, there's a better look at it. I don't really think y'all got a super good look at it at the beginning, but like I said, just a little 4-inch drop shot worm, Bass Pro brand. Seems to really do the trick this time of year, especially in the past few days. Do you have a bite? Come out here with you.
Oh my God.
First fish, guys. AJ's getting salty. Hey, no, but look, if it wasn't for AJ, I wouldn't be up here on this dock right now. Hey. It's a start. Top of the mouth every time. These drop shot hooks. There we go, guys. On the 4-inch drop shot worm. Not a huge fish, but it's a good fish for the winter time, isn't it, AJ?
Yep.
See you later. All right, guys, I think we're on to something. This is pretty, it's pretty far out there. I don't know what's out there. I don't know if there's like a tree. I haven't felt anything. It could be like just a hump or a, there's another one, AJ. Hey, AJ, this is a better fish. Hey guys, AJ, this is a better fish, man. I'm gonna go get those weights, all right? Guys, we have a better fish on. Oh, head shaking. Oh, AJ, I think we're on to something. Oh, should I flip him? Oh, yes, sir. That's not a bad one at all for this pond. Look at the colors on that one. It's a nice fish. AJ's weight actually flew off. So now I gotta make a run back to the truck and go get him a weight because we are on to something now, folks. That's a nice one there. Real pretty. These fish in the wintertime get these real vibrant colors and just real pretty vertical lines or lateral lines. But two fish back to back on the same spot. Like I said, I don't know what holds them out there, but we're definitely on to something. Let's get her back. Dude, that's so much fun, man. That was really crazy how that all happened. Let's see if I can get 3 for 3 out there. That's exactly where it was. See where I just casted? Right in that area. I found what they're on. Definitely found what they're on. They're on a big tree out there. Me and AJ both broke off. I just hit the tree. I just went over it, my weight did. I just let it sink. That was it. They're on that tree, AJ. Cast straight out in front of me. I went over the limb and let it sink. You heard me. And then this fish here picked it up. So AJ, they're a little bit closer than what we thought. Right there. That's him, folks. My weight went over that limb. I let it sink and he went, doop, just tapped it. There we go, guys. This is fish number 3. Not the biggest, but we did find what they're doing. Out here, they're hugging a pretty big, seems to be a lay down up under the water. About 8 to 9 feet out there. And you just put it over the limb and they, boom, hit it every time. Let's go get another one. He's coming up here. We'll talk to him. Hey, no, sir.
Yeah, what you doing on my fish?
Yes, sir.
I don't care if you're on. I'm just messing with you. What do y'all, I just want to know what y'all are filming.
Oh, I'm filming a little YouTube video, man.
Yeah. Y'all but, catch anything?
Wearing them out. On a little drop shot.
Right thing. My boy fishes every morning before he goes to school because he's dumb.
Okay? But that's
well,
what I did.
He caught a 19-pound bass in this thing on a brim pole.
Really?
Took him 40 minutes to get it in. And I got on to him, I said, boy.
You know that's almost a world record, right?
No.
World record bass is 22 pounds.
Well, buddy, it's the world record's in here then, because they're bigger than that.
Yeah.
He's got one of the smaller ones. They've been in here for years. I mean, they're like, we don't do anything with them. They throw them back.
Right.
I've got it on video. If I can, trying to think where I've got it. But anyway, he reeled it. It took him 40 minutes, and I kept saying, I said, boy, I said, you got that line hung up. You fixed to break the pole. He breaks poles all the time.
Really?
He's going to break that pole. Cut that line.
It was a bass?
Yes. But man, it sure his head was this big. He brought it in. It was on that corner down there with tine. On that, well, you see them red seats?
I see that.
Every evening at 4 o'clock.
Well, they feed fish over there. They feed the catfish. There's a catfish they feed over there.
25 years, Ty has been feeding him fish down.
Because I've talked to him before. Him and his wife sit out there.
Them catfish are bigger than that. Them catfish. I mean, I bet you they're 3 foot, 4 foot long. Right. Good look, yeah.
Man, we just make a little YouTube video, man. Yeah, it's a pretty day to be doing it.
Yeah, I just messing with you.
Man, I appreciate you letting us fish in your dock, man.
I don't care about it.
I usually fish all just right here. You've probably seen me out here. I used to stand out here a lot.
I have.
And I usually bring my camera with me.
I've never seen you with a camera, though. That's why I said, what
are you
doing?
Yeah. I'm
curious. So, how old are you? 21 now?
I'm about to be 21, yeah. So, yeah, you started pulling up. I was like, man. I was like, oh, I hope I'm not making, because I mean, some people are like that. I just didn't know. Because
no,
I've seen.
No, everybody here is old people.
Well, yeah, because I've seen them feed the fish and they'll talk to me. I know the guy that just moved in. Well, I don't know if he's still over there.
Man, right, y'all, I appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
I hope you catch that big one. She's in there.
Thank you, man. Y'all tell me if you believe his story about his son catching a 19-pound bass out of this pond. He said that his son did. Y'all leave down in the comments what y'all think. I'm pretty sure y'all heard that at the truck. But y'all leave down in the comments what y'all think of that and let me know. I've only really caught fish from anywhere from 1 to 3 pounds out of this pond, and I've been fishing here for a pretty good bit. So y'all just let me know how y'all would have taken that story, and I'd like to see what y'all have to say about that. Yep. They're on this side of the tree. Guys, this is so much fun, being able to find out what these fish are doing, especially in the winter time like this, on drop shots. And every time. It's dank. I just went over the tree. One more. They're all about the same size, but I mean, it's fun that we're catching them. Oh, they're feisty fish, man. I was telling you, they fight hard here. Look. There we go, folks. Fish number 4 or 5. I can't really remember. One of the two. Like I said, they're all about the same size, though. Nothing too special. Still catching them on that drop shot worm, though. Well, me and AJ are leaving this spot. Ended up catching like 5 fish though, pretty much all back to back, but then they get pressured really, really fast and just decide to shut off a little bit. I think it's super crazy how the owner of that house right over there came up to me and he was acting like he was about to kick me out, and I was like, golly, fish are biting. And that's just the worst. I'm still kind of iffy on the whole story about his son catching the 19 pound bass. I don't know if y'all know, but that is a giant fish. And I want to say the record here in Mississippi is right at 18 pounds. But he told me that his son caught a 19 out of this little pond, and that there are way bigger ones out here because he has seen them with his eyes. I've been fishing out here for almost about a year and a half, I'd guess. And I think the biggest fish I've caught out of here is maybe 3.5 or 4. I've never seen any fish over 3.5 or 4 out here. I'm not saying it's not true, but I've been fishing for a really long time, and a 19 pound bass is a giant. So I don't know, we're done with this spot. Gonna go back, chill out for a little bit, and then we'll head to spot number 2 later this afternoon. So guys, it is the next day. We went fishing yesterday afternoon, but it just did not turn out good. I think we only caught one small fish, so I did not include any of that footage in this video, but came back out here to where we were catching them yesterday, where that man told us a 19 pound bass was caught. Still kind of hard to believe, but we're out here. Got my stepbrother Peyton.
Come on, guys.
But didn't want to bring the big camera out here. Just got my chest mount on. It's actually raining right now as we speak, so I didn't want to bring the big camera out and it start pouring and it gets soaked. So better to be safe than sorry, but we're still gonna have a fun time, catch some more fish. Me and old AJ are gonna come back to our OG spot on this pier and see if we can't catch them off these trees out here, just like we did yesterday. I'm actually gonna be throwing a Texas rig today. Texas rig trick worm and green pumpkin. AJ's doing the same. Peyton's throwing a rattle trap, a crawfish colored rattle trap. So, his parents have one. I have a fish. Dude, this feels like a nicer one, Peyton. Oh my gosh. That's not a bad one for this place, is it? Dead sticking it.
I got a fish.
Dead sticking it, son. Let's move this out the way. Hey. There we go. Fish number 1 on the Texas rig. I was dead sticking it, man. That's how you do it right there. That's how you do it right there. Fish number 1. There you go. We ought to be in there. AJ, go that way. We're gonna have it all covered. There you go. He said that was trash. I got a fish. Fish number 2, guys. They're way out there. Yesterday they weren't that far out there. They're kind of nice, but I'm dead sticking that bait. I'm not working it. Whoop. Fish number 2. Hey, that's the biggest first one. He gone.
Fish right yeah. There, and we throw right there and catch the fish.
Well, I was doing that yesterday with AJ. Here. I got one, Peyton. That's the tree. No, it's a fish. He had me wrapped around. He had me wrapped around. Oh, come on now. Guys, fish number 3. Set the hook on Peyton's rod. I thought I was hung up, but no. There you go. They're getting smaller though. On that trick worm. He's been caught before.
Oh yeah, that is.
Number 3. Straight out. Alright guys, we are at spot number 2, and this is actually somewhat a hidden pond on these railroad tracks, and there's actually a train coming right now as we speak. So here in about 10 minutes we're going to have to move out of the way. But I've caught a lot of fish here in the past, mostly back in my high school days, 3-4 years ago. I hadn't really been out here since, so I got Peyton with me. AJ decided to leave. He doesn't have the patience to do it as long as we do, but I'm gonna keep throwing this trick worm around because that seemed to do the trick earlier this morning at the other pond, and just see what we can catch from there. So hopefully we don't get hit by this train. It's like mostly rock and just algae growing on them. Maybe too. I've caught a lot of fish on flukes out here, like the double rig fluke. They probably have countless types of food in this pond, though. I got a fish. Look at the colors on them. Look at the colors on this one, Peyton. Is that not pretty? First fish. That's a super pretty bass right there. He is probably close to a pound and a half. Before they come out of where that tree line is. You have one. Golly. I got that on camera too. Peyton is hooked up. That one is pretty too.
Catching on that watermelon seed trick worm. First one of the day.
Number two on the pond.
Heck yeah. Let's get him back. Awesome. He dancing for you.
Dude, that was, I thought you had a giant. It looked like you did for a second.
Man, I set the hook. I thought he was like 3 or 4 pounds.
Perfect.
That's perfect. Looks like a doe from what I can tell.
Yeah. The only buck I've seen was that one back behind me back here.
That's kind of like cool, bro.
There's a ton of them that cross up here too. I have a fish. Dude, he's going around the log. That could have been bad right there. That's a smaller one, but look how colorful these fish are in this pond.
I'm ready for one.
Super pretty bass. That's a wintertime bass right there. Real colorful. This water's a little bit clear. Oh, I'm gonna have to throw him back a little bit. There you go.
Just now. Must hit me in the nuts.
All right, guys, for the most part, fishing slowed down. The rain picked up, the wind moved in. We caught a few small ones, just nothing too special for the camera, but over the past few days, I had a great time fishing. Ended up catching quite a few fish, but y'all be sure to leave a like on this video, comment down below what your favorite wintertime bait is, and y'all stay tuned for the next video. Probably won't be long before I post my next one since it's about to start warming up here in Mississippi. It doesn't usually stay cold too long, so y'all stay tuned for that, and thank you for watching.